Good evening. So I was asked to tell you something about Chalmers University and our role in this project and to make it visible. So if we're now looking at these slides, then maybe you are missing over there Chalmers. So let me show you what should have been there. And to also remind you about these things, I made sure that you, during the whole my presentation, you can look here at the building. If you look up top there, there it's standing Studios Rerum Naturae e Mat. And above the mass, I can see there is some picture which reminds you of this one. So this was founded, it is written here in 1829. This is the next one. Yes, it's coming up. This was a rich merchant which made his fortune with the Swedish East Indian Company and who donated much of his money to make a, well, in the first place, this Chalmers Sleuder School on, which was in the first place a foundational, a vocational school, which just trained craftsmen, but it grew to be a polytechnic, which later on became a state university with the right to degree, doctoral degrees. And then, well, this other thing is not so important that they changed some bits. So let me tell you where we are. So this is in the north. You can see Sweden and Gothenburg is on something maybe you did not know, but there is something like a west coast of Sweden that's just opposite Denmark. And there we have two campuses. Let's see. So, of course, Sweden is, you saw, maybe we're going back, you see Sweden, well, you see it's a very big country, but in total there are only 9 million inhabitants, so we're also not having that many universities. Gothenburg is the second largest city with 500,000 inhabitants. Always the harbor was very important. So it is indeed the biggest harbor of Scandinavia. And one of the goals now for Chalmers University of Technology is to work for a sustainable future. So one thing, we have these two campuses, they are now connected by a bus line which is by electrical buses. And of course, our mission is education. You can read, so let's see. So I'm just going here. You see, here you see the one campus, that's the old one. This is also the old one. Here at the harbor, there we're seeing the new. Here is the, it's written, yes, the IT university. So we have different programs. And as I said, the harbor has always been important. So one of the things which is special for Chalmers that we educate ship's officers. But mostly we have a bachelor in science and engineering and a master and 41 master programs. Of course, I learned yesterday how many students there are here in Turin. Of course, we cannot compete with that. But so we have 17 institutions, and it's not very good, very visible. One of them is the one where I work, and this is the mathematical science. Let me tell you a bit more what mathematical science is doing and why we are a partner here in this project. This is because of, no, this was this thing. We at mathematical science which is a joint department of Chalmers University Technology, University of Technology and the University of Gothenburg.
Not only for the weather.
So but this is the Mademoiselle Science, so this is as well as the Technical University, as the University of Gothenburg. And what was the problem? Of course, we see, and this is a common problem, that the students who come are not very good in math. So what was our aim? Was to give the students a better preparation. And for that, indeed, there is a course during summer, and indeed, so how are you then doing that? You make it a distance learning course that they can do it on the beach, if there is fine weather. So this is a distance learning course. All the materials and communication is done through our learning management system. And all the examination is done with Maple TA. Let me not dwell on this. This is what our. But there are lots of students, and there has to be a lot of tests. So there are 68,000 test sets with 500,000 questions. And of course, this is impossible to grade manually. Here, this is interesting. Here you see how our program is still grows. This is the number of students who logged in on the management system, and you see this is during, so the program opens in March, and then you see, well, what's written here. Yes, in April, so in May they start, and you see they really log in June and July. Until August, and you see also the red one is this year, 2016, that seems to be a little bit less than last year, but the number of students is growing over the years since we started in... and the students are quite satisfied. So we have now, this is a big project with this, so we have a spin-off effect that we now use this Maple TA in a lot of our courses to have basically homework tests. We are not doing as in Delft that we are having exams for the students, but the new thing is that we are examining the participation in the computer labs in the MATLAB. This is quite interesting project. And also at the University of Gothenburg, where we're teaching, we're using that. And let me come back then to the University of Gothenburg, because so one of the things which mathematics at the University of Gothenburg do is train teachers. There is also a big movement. So there are for teachers in the region, there are regular days where new things are presented. So I think the materials which we are developing in this course will be very interesting give them to our teacher trainers, and on this way to promote our material. And that was all I wanted to tell you. Thank you.
Thank you, Jan.